Hello students, so far we were learning about congruent triangles. So congruent means whose angles and sides all will be equal. So we were learning about equal triangles. So now we will learn about inequalities, that means unequal sides in a triangle. By this term we can understand that we are talking about scalene triangles. So scalene triangles, we have three unequal sides. So now look at this diagram first. Suppose this triangle, these three sides are unequal. Now if I draw another point here, so keeping the point A, B and C, B and C remain same, I'm keeping A dashed, then again A double dash. So in this way I'm changing only this point. Okay, so as am I changing these points, what happened is if I join all of these points with B and C, we will see that we are getting unequal triangles. And also what we can see is this triangle, this overall triangle is greater than this small triangle, and also this triangle is greater than both of this triangle and this triangle. So if we actually put it in this way, that this triangle A dashed BC is greater than ABC, also this triangle becomes greater than all of these two triangles. So why? Because we can see that this side is increasing gradually along with this side also, and also hence what happens is the triangle is becoming bigger. Okay, so this is how we will learn inequalities. So there are certain theorems for inequalities. So next we will learn the theorems. So now we have the next theorem, theorem 6. So theorem 6 says that if two sides of a triangle are unequal, so that means it won't be any isosceles triangle. So what happens is the angle opposite to the longer side is larger. So let us now draw a triangle. Now for understanding this concept, what I have done is I have drawn a line segment AB, and there is an arc here which I have drawn, and in this arc I have marked 5 points P, Q, R, S and T. Okay, so at first we will join one by one this line segment AB with these points. Okay, so at first I have joined with point P. So with point P I have joined B first and then A. A I am marking with the dotted line. Okay, so now if I consider that this PB is the longest side, so what will happen? We will get an angle here A. So now as this side becomes longer, how this angle will become greater? So that we will understand, because it says that if the angle opposite to the longer side, so as the side becomes longest, the angle will also become large. Okay, so this is how we will prove it. So at first, see, this side is of length this much. Now if I move to this length will increase. If you measure, this length QB will increase after joining this line segment QB. So now the next I am drawing line segment from Q to point B and point A. Okay, again in point A I will draw it with the dotted line, and with point B I will draw it with the normal line. Okay, so this is how I have drawn a line segment from Q to B and A. Okay, now see that this angle is definitely smaller than this big angle, isn't it? So angle is becoming big. And also if you look at this side, if you measure this in drawing in an arc like this, you will see that the side QB is greater than side PB. So what happens is side QB is greater than side PB. So also what happens is this angle, that is QAB, so angle QAB becomes greater than angle PAB. So this is angle QAB which is greater, and angle PAB, this becomes smaller than this one. So similarly, if I draw two lines from R, S and T, joining B with normal line and A with dotted line. Okay, so let us draw it. From R I am joining B, and from R I am joining A. Again from S I am joining B. So this will be a straight line. So by mistake, I have drawn it like this. So I have drawn from S and from T also. Okay, so as we can see that this angle A is becoming gradually bigger, isn't it? At first it was only this much. Now from Q it is becoming this big. Now from R it is becoming more big, S more bigger, and from up to T it becomes the largest angle between all of these angles. Okay, also if you observe the line segments, PB is smaller than QB, again RB is becoming greater than these two line segments. Now SB is becoming greater than all of these three line segments, RB, QB and PB. Also this TB becomes the longest line segment. So as the line segment opposite to the angle is becoming longest, the opposite angle, that is angle A, is becoming longer gradually. Okay, so let us write it down. So what happens is this TB, this is the longest side. So this is greater than the next line segment SB. So SB. Now the next one we have RB, then we have QB, and the smallest one we have PB. So also we can say that this angle A is becoming greater. So that means angle, first one angle is TAB. So angle TAB is the longest. Then next is angle SAB. Then next we have angle RAB. Next angle QAB, and the last one is angle PAB. So this we can conclude from this diagram. Okay, so in congruent triangles we have already learned that if the triangle sides and angles are same, then the triangles are same. Now if the angles and sides are bigger, then the triangle becomes bigger. So that means the biggest triangle here will be TAB. Triangle TAB, the whole triangle will be the biggest triangle. Then next we will have SAB, then RAB, then QAB and then PAB. So we can say that therefore triangle TAB is the longest triangle. Then the next one we will have SAB, then next we have RAB, then next we have triangle QAB and the last one is triangle PAB. So this is the theorem 6. So this is how we can understand theorem 6, that it says that as the side becomes longer, the angle also becomes longer. And the converse of this is the next theorem, theorem 7. Now look at theorem 7. It says that in any triangle, the side opposite to the larger angle is longer. So we can see that this is the larger angle, TAB. So the opposite side of it is TB. So TB is the longest side. Okay, so this is just the converse theorem of the previous one. So both of these theorems can be understood by this diagram and these concepts. Okay, so now we will next move on to the next theorem. And now the last theorem of this chapter, theorem 8, it says that the sum of any two sides of a triangle is greater than the third side. So this theorem can be easily proved by drawing any triangle. So here I am drawing a triangle ABC. So I have drawn this triangle and the sides here is AB is 4 cm, BC is 5 cm and AC is 7 cm. So here we have to see that which is the greatest side. So clearly side AC is the greatest side. Now if side AB and BC, I add them up, then we can say that AB plus BC, these two sides will become 4 plus 5, that is 9. And side AC is how much? It is 7 cm. So clearly we can say that AB plus BC, both of them are greater than side AC. So if I add any two sides, that is not the greater side. Okay, so those two sides will be greater than the third side. And also if I add the other two sides, like suppose 7 and 5, if I add them, this gives us 12 cm. So this is definitely greater than the third side. And also if I add 7 plus 4, then it becomes 11 cm. So that is greater than 5 cm. So that means sum of any two sides of a triangle is always greater than the third sides. And if it is not greater, then this will not form a triangle. So suppose I have taken 2 cm here and 5 cm here. So 2 plus 5 is 7. So then also we can join with the 7 cm. But if I have 1 cm in this side and 7 cm this side, then we will see that the 7 cm will not join this. So it will become greater. So if you join 7 cm from C with 1 cm from this side, then the side will become greater side. It will be less than 7 cm. So definitely it should be a triangle having the third side as greater than the other two sides. Okay. So these are the theorems from this chapter. So go through all the theorems. Next day we will do exercise 7.4. Thank you, students.